What's good, YouTube? Look, we got Jimmy High Roller. When trash talking goes horribly wrong, I'm expecting this to be a banger. No cap. So let's get to it. Bro, this clip is hilarious, bro. I found it so hilarious. Man really smiles, looks over. The Luka special mod. Trash talking Hall of Fame. Not because Devin Booker's trash talking worked, not because he actually backed it up or anything, but because of the absolute obliteration that was to follow. Devin Booker did not know it at the time, but this is where it all ended. Goofy, yeah, boy. Moments before disaster. Today's video is sponsored by Skillshare. Shout out to Skillshare, though. Go Jimmy High Roller, bro. This is the text my brother sent me just moments before witnessing the biggest playoff basketball I've ever seen in my entire life. I didn't believe it, so I had to tune into the game myself. And sure enough, there it was. Mod. That is fucking crazy, bro.
Record-breaking 64-win Suns team, fully healthy, is getting dog-walked in a Game 7 with their season on the line. Okay, well, I wasn't able to watch the first half, so I'm assuming those measly 27 points had to have come from Chris Paul and Devin Booker. I mean, there's no way they just didn't score. Huh. So, after all that traffic, whooping and hollering, after going up 2-0 in the series, this was the best the Suns had to offer a couple weeks ago.
Come on, bro.
How the Nets, and specifically Kevin Durant, had one of the worst playoff meltdowns in recent history. But, we got a new contender. Of all the players in this year's playoffs, Chris Paul had possibly more to prove than anyone else. After a career of bad luck and, quite frankly, bad playoff performances, NBA fans were eager to see if he could lead his team to the NBA Finals again and redeem himself.
Yo, the footage is getting so clean, bro. Like, with people warming up and shit.
We should have known better. Fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. Lose an NBA record 7 consecutive Game 7s, and shame on everyone. Why am I even watching at this point? But it's one thing for Chris Paul to fall apart in Game 7. For one reason,
hold on.
He's been doing it his entire career. But the entire Suns roster, how does the one seed, the best regular season team in the NBA, fall apart this badly with their season on the line? In the first half of Game 7 against the Mavericks, the Suns' starting five combined for 15 points on 29 shots. Luka Doncic, by himself, had 27 points on 12 shots. Chris Paul and Devin,
I just had to say something
for a whopping 3 points in the first half. 3 points.
That's crazy.
Of course, those 3 points came from the foul line. Neither of them made a
single shot. Oh, hell no.
The Suns starting five mustered up just 37 points in 143 minutes on the court. Luka put up 35 points in just 30 minutes. I don't think I've ever seen an NBA game in my entire life that was over halfway through the second quarter.
Yeah, that's crazy.
Why Luka didn't drop a 50-point triple-double on these boys was because the man was on the bench by the third quarter, prepping for the Warriors in the next round. In this series featuring the Suns and the Mavericks,
shit is wild.
Luka had more points than pure scorer Devin Booker, had more assists than league-leading assist man Chris Paul, had more rebounds than 7-foot center DeAndre Jordan, and had more steals than Defensive Player of the Year runner-up Mikal Bridges. The man beat the
Suns so
bad,
no.
The franchise had to write an apology letter to their fans. Devin Booker spent the 2022 NBA season building having the best season of his career. And yet, somehow, when it mattered most, Booker put together the worst playoff game of his entire career. The man didn't even put up a fight. It's like there's no fire in him. He's not rising up in these big games. And this big game mentality is what separates guys like Luka and Giannis from others. Sure, these guys are vastly more talented than their peers, and that definitely helps. But just as valuable as their skill set and physical tools,
like,
is their will to
Devin Booker was supposed to be nice with it, bro.
Die trying, then lose
lose a game seven like this, the man won't back down to anyone, and he has the game to back it up. I mean, seriously, is there anything better in sports than a superstar who plays better under pressure? A player that can take the trash talk, spit it right back, and make you regret it. Luka said it best after their game five loss against the Suns.
Everybody acting tough when they're up. I got tough when they're up.
How confident you have to be to say this out loud after going down 2-3 in the playoffs? This killer mentality, almost like a basketball hitman, taking names and seeking revenge, is something you're
either shit's crazy, bro.
Or you aren't. Players like Luka, Giannis, Jimmy Butler, Ja Morant are all cut from the same cloth as guys like Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant, and Larry Bird. There is no end to
what was the list? Okay.
Cloth as guys like Michael Jordan, Kobe Bryant, and Larry Bird.
Valid.
There is no end to what they will do to win. It's almost psychotic at times. Not every night will be some monumental performance, but you can guarantee that they'll go down swinging. We often wonder why some players, although extremely talented, seem to never step up to the plate when all the chips are on the table.
What is B-roll, bro? Why you show Harden and Ben Simmons like that? Why you show Chris Paul while saying that?
But it's there. And the thing
nah, he's not wrong.
Don't have it is that they tend to underestimate the guys who do have it. In the 90s, players were legitimately scared to trash talk Michael Jordan. I mean, they already knew that there was a slim chance he wasn't going to dismantle them. But at least if they kept quiet, Michael might just spare them from embarrassments in front of friends and family. Everybody's tough when they're up. And wouldn't you know it, come game seven when the Mavericks were up, Devin Booker was quietly sitting on the bench with not a single word to say. Which really makes you wonder if Devin Booker...
The nigga just called Devin Booker pussy, bruh? Is that what Luka said, basically? He said, yo, Devin, you're a real pussy, bruh. You ain't shit, Devin.
CP is one of the greatest point guards of all time. I want him to close out a game with everything on the line.
Just a little trouble.
Slander campaign for the last few days, and whether it's true or not, he spoke about how NBA teams aren't all that worried about facing Chris Paul.
CP3, he's gonna be a Hall of Fame. No question about it. Yeah, right? No question about it.
Yeah.
Early the night before playing the Phoenix Suns? Hell no.
You mean as a team, or would you talk about Chris Paul individually?
Chris Paul individually.
Okay.
No. I'm going to Steak 44 over there in Phoenix. I'm going to have me a nice little wine, probably sweat it out, and but the pregame shoot around and get ready for Chris Paul. Steph Curry, I'm going to bed at 8 o'clock. Mom, don't call me. My girl, don't call me. I'm locked in right now. It's not it's two different moms.
This is crazy.
And although that's really rich coming from a guy who spent the last 8 years getting spanked by Chris Paul, I think there's probably a lot of truth to what he's saying. Chris Paul just doesn't have that hitman mentality that other greats have. And Devin Booker
doesn't
have it either. This whole game...
Everyone thought Devin Booker had it, though. Last year's finals, everybody really thought Devin Booker had it, bro.
Devin Booker was complaining about getting double-teamed at an open gym. Instead of embracing the challenge, he became frustrated with it. Instead of welcoming the double team to enhance his game, he complained about it. Some fans often say Devin Booker is the closest thing to Kobe Bryant in today's NBA.
Fuck no, nigga.
Get it twisted. Because you want to know what Kobe Bryant said when he was getting double teamed?
Would people double team you going to
pick up? Oh, yeah.
And what do you think about it?
Like, say you got to send another one.
Send a third one.
Get out of the way. I got this. Mentality to his game. He will only get so far. Two superstars don't just happen to score three combined points in the first half of their biggest game of the season. It's one thing to get out to a slow start. But this is the result of a player who lives and thrives off of big moments, having a field day with two players that can't help but to freeze up in big moments. Either you have it or you don't. Some players lack it, some players are honing it, and some players are made of it. Hope you all enjoy it. And as always, until next time.
Yeah. Oh, thanks.
Then we'll come back to you.
Alright. Hey, bro. What the fuck was I gonna say? Luka has it. Devin doesn't. Man's really thought Devin would have it. Everyone expecting Devin to have it. He really didn't. It's tough. I got Milwaukee next year, though.